Hey everyone, it's Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to add form to your vector illustrations. Here we have our tiger that we colored from our last video, how to color in vector. And here you can see I've got my base colors set up with the gradients added. And just real quick as an overview, I'm going to share my shadow and light layers with you. When we turn on the shadow layer, you see we start getting some form, starts adding some depth to those base colors. When I'm working on the shadow shapes, I tend to keep the shadow shapes below the object. So even for instance here, I've got the hard black shape here for the stripes of his fur. I've come in and I've put the shadow shape below that. Typically in illustrations like this, when I'm working on them, I'm thinking of the light source kind of coming from above and in front of the tiger or the subject itself. So if the light source is coming from the front and top, we're going to get a lot of light at the top of his head. It'll recede into shadow as we get into the creases of the eyes. And then the nose comes forward a bit more and we'll catch that light again. So I've kind of got a light, dark, light, and then it gets darker again as we're adding the shadows to the bottom of these forms. That could be demonstrated a bit better. Let me turn on my light layer here. And you can see how much more volume and form that adds. So when we come in here and look now a little bit closer, on my light layer, if I turn it on and off, you can see I've kept my light shapes to the top of the forms. So the light shape here is above the dark black stripe. It's also at the very top of his head here. When we look more at his nose and his cheeks, you can see there's a lack of light in the dark creases of his eyes where those shadows sit. But where his cheek kind of comes back closer to the light source as well as the top of his nose here, you can see I've hit that with additional lighting to help round out this form here. So we've got the light coming at the top. As it rolls down the form, it'll turn to shadow, and then we've got our darkest shadow here being this black line. And again, this form here will come back out, catching some of the light before rolling over and receding back into shadow here. So let's hop over to the pixel persona and do some drawing. I want to better demonstrate some of the ideas that I'm talking about here. So I've got a pixel layer set up. I'm going to grab a brush. And let's just take a look at this whole shape here. We're just considering the left side of his muzzle here. I'm just going to flat this in with a medium grayish blue tone here. So if we were to add the light coming in from the top here, hitting the top of the form, it'll be lightest, closest to the light source, the top of these forms here. And as it recedes down and away from the light, it'll get darker as that form turns and rolls into shadow. The lightest parts being closest to the light source there. So basically what we're kind of looking at here, if we've got the light coming from the top, it's going to hit the top of these forms here, and then it's going to roll down and recede into shadow. Right now we're back over in the designer persona, and I'm going to show you how I approach the shadows. So what I go ahead and do is I'm going to create a new layer. This layer will be above my color layer, but below my line art layer. And I'm going to come up here to the layer style where it says pass through. And I'm going to set this to multiply, which will darken whatever color we put on this layer. and it will interact with the color ball behind it. What I usually like to do for shadows is I typically stick with cool shadows and warmer lights. So I usually pick something kind of in the purple area. I'm going to make it quite light because on the multiply, it'll darken up rather quickly. So coming in here, we're going to focus on his muzzle here. My black line art here are my deepest, darkest shadows and are also indicate the bottom of the forms. So we would consider this form here with the light hitting the top here and then rolling down to the forms. So when I'm creating these shadow shapes, I'm going to come in here. I'm going to create them right above and in line with the black line art. And then we would go ahead and fill that shape there. And we want to go ahead and continue working these shadow shapes in here. So the shadow shape is going right above the shape of the dark line art, which again indicates my darkest shadows. And then we could go ahead and continue doing the same down here as well. We'll speed this up just a little bit to get, just to give you the idea of what we're trying to go for here. So you can see now how I have these shapes. The shadow shape is right above the darkest line art that I have here, so the shape is rolling over. The light will hit here and roll down over into the shadow areas. So we're going to do something very similar for the lighting. I'm going to create a new layer over my shadow layer here, and once again I'm going to come up to the pass-through layer style, and here I'm going to put it on screen. However, you can try screen, overlay, or any of the soft, hard, or vivid light layers. It just depends on what color you're using and how it'll interact with the color behind it. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and select screen. I'm going to grab my pen tool here. And continuing to work on the muzzle here, when I'm adding the light shapes, just like the shadow shapes here, I'm trying to kind of go in line with the line art shapes that I currently have down. So I'll move this light shape around the line art. And we'll select a soft yellow. So now you can see that the light here is hitting the top portion of this form and then rolling around and receding into shadow before getting to the darkest shadows, which are my black line art here. Something else that we can do. This light shape here has got a pretty hard edge to it, which could work depending on what style you're going for. But something that I typically like to do, especially for the lights, although you could also do it for the shadows, is come up here to the effects panel and add a Gaussian blur. I'll just blur that out a little bit. It'll fuzz the edges of that shape, kind of helping add to the roundness of that form. So that's something that I like to do in order to make that shape a little more round and softer as it rolls down into the shadows. So what we'll go ahead and do from here is continue working on our light and shadow shapes, and we'll speed up this process a little bit. everyone. I just wanted to share something I've been working on. It's my first full course and will focus on lighting objects in Vector. It will be available for purchase later this year. I will also have an introductory version available on YouTube covering basic lighting principles and concepts. I'm super excited to share this with you. It's something I've been working on for a while now. Thank you so much for your support. Now back to the video. And with that, we've now added form to our tiger face by using light and shadow. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. Keep chasing your dreams, and until next time.